We welcome you to enjoy this Blackstone audiobook from ABDO Magic Wagon, books that kids love in the classroom. Get ready for an amazing listening experience that connects the school library to your home and keeps the learning going.
Moto Maki's Ghostly Mysteries, The Haunted Umbrella, by Anita Yasuda. Chapter 1. Do Not Touch.
"Come on, Moto," shouts my best friend, VJ. "My mom will give us a ride."
I shake my head and scramble over the school fence. My nose twitches with the stink of the drain on Tima Road. On the ground are feathers, pens, and other lost things. Perfect, I think. There must be something here to add to my collection. I fish an orange and black tiger eye bead out of the open gutter. Next to it is a shiny lion's head coin. I shove the lost things into my pockets. That's when I spy the sagging box marked, "Do Not Touch." My hands plunge under the lid. What is at the bottom, I wonder? A pirate map? A top secret invention? I tug a tattered umbrella out of the box. Aw, it's junk. I sigh and toss it aside.
"Don't anger the ghosts,"
comes a sharp voice from behind. It's an old woman wearing a faded green shawl.
"Huh?" I say. "What ghosts? These are lost things."
"Haunted things,"
she replies and backs away. Her eyes glitter darkly. Just a weird woman, I think, and hurry on. Thunder booms nearby. My eyes follow the clouds as they scatter like bats. The trees ahead creak and groan. Their branches claw at the sky. I sniff the damp air, and my forehead crinkles. Treasure hunting will have to wait.
"Hurry, Moto," I tell myself. "You can make it home before it rains."
The storm answers. Warm raindrops wash down my face. With every step, the thunder gets closer and the wind stronger. I fly past food stalls, squeezed together like a beehive. A great gust of wind snatches the red cap from my head. My hair stands straight up. Chapter 2. The Temple. I grip my backpack until my hands ache and race to the shortcut. There is an old wood temple at the end of the path. Only the way is blocked by low green boughs. I squeeze through and plunge into the darkness. Something crunches behind me. "Don't stop," I tell myself. My legs pump harder. I race up the stone steps to the temple gate. My shorts and t-shirt cling to my skin. A puddle of water forms at my feet. My body presses against a dry space, and I heave a sigh. Safe, I think. Above my head, thick vines knit together like doughy fingers. Light flickers off the temple's large bell. Fearsome-looking statues stand tall on either side of the gate. I feel like they are waiting for something to chew on. "Rain, rain, go away," I sing softly. "I wish for sun today." In the middle of my song, my eyes catch a flash of movement. "Hello?" I call out. "Is someone there?"
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.